Obviously.
Greatest Easter song ever. Funny, huh? Man don't want you in the club. When you pussy pop, you start fights in the club. You come through when you're in a car. Bitches all in your mind, know you a star. You come with four or five holes, trying to fight anything straight out the door. All right, welcome back to another episode of the Perfect 10 Podcast, brought to you by Boot Crew Media.
There it is.
I am one half of your host, Jacob Erdy. Alongside me, as you already been knowing, is Daniel Dees.
That's me.
And yeah, you know, it was kind of tough to pick a Lent Easter related song. I tried to look and see if VeggieTales had an Easter song. But then I was like, wait a second, Bunny Hop, you know? Obvious. So yeah, by that intro, and today is
Monday.
Lundi Gras. Yes.
Let's go.
Fat Monday. So tomorrow, Fat Tuesday, you'll be getting all your sinning out. I don't know if most of y'all understood what Fat Tuesday was all about, but that's
fatten you up for Lent.
That's the celebration. You just indulge in all the nastiness. Then you cleanse yourself.
Yeah.
Now, you know,
get right with the Lord.
Yes. So we are going to give y'all the top 10 things to give up for Lent.
They did not have that plan for Fat Tuesday when they created it.
Right.
They did not expect what we did to it.
Take it and run with it. You know,
we didn't run with it. We fucking flew. we just want y'all to eat. What are y'all doing down here?
Right. Yeah. Yeah. What's it? Overeat. Glutton, you know?
Yeah. Well, we were an inclusive bunch. We put all the deadly sins in that bitch.
It's supposed to be the extent of it, I believe.
We got greed, people hoarding up the beads, wrath, fighting, lust. Vanity, people just dressing up to the nines.
All
the sins are represented.
They did it all the way, you know?
When we do it big.
So, you know, top 10 things to give up for Lent. Now, trivia question. So, do you know when the first Lent was celebrated? What year? Obviously, it was AD.
Yeah, I know it was AD.
It's actually like longer after than I had expected. Not terribly long after.
No, it's going to be in the triple digits. I know that.
Okay.
Shit, I know this.
Okay.
I'm going to get it.
Okay. I mean,
no, hold on. I'm going deep in the well on this.
Hey, dig deep.
I'm digging.
Don't be looking at my phone, bro.
I'm looking right at that dresser right there.
I never would have guessed this number, but I never looked it up before either.
Yes or no?
Okay.
Is it in the 300s?
Yes.
All right, so I'm getting there. I know this. I know this.
All right.
Because I've been asked this before in trivia. So I should know this.
I mean, hey, props to you for already narrowing it down to one specific area.
If I get it within...
I'll give it to you within 5.
Okay.
And you already know it's 300-something, so...
325.
It's 325.
Shit. I swear to God, I didn't. I wanted to say either 325 or 330 or 320.
Right.
I wanted to say one of those, so I just picked the middle one since you gave me 5 leeway, so I just went with it.
325 AD.
Let's go!
That's pretty impressive, dude, honestly. All right. See, you're welcome for me asking these number questions all the time.
Sometimes I get it.
You're getting better at guessing numbers, dude.
No, it's just I've been asked this before. And usually when I get asked a question, I get it wrong. I don't forget it.
I hear you.
You verified the 300, so I was thinking of 320s.
Okay.
And I was like, wait, is it 330? No, it can't. Then you gave me the 5 leeway, so I just took it.
So, yeah, there you go, people. First,
if you would not have given me that 5, I probably would have said 330.
Also, it's annoying to me. I do Lent every year. People are like, oh, I didn't know you were Catholic. I'm not. You don't have to be Catholic. It's not a Catholic holiday.
You just love the Lord.
It's a Christian holiday. Yes. So
you love God, Jesus.
All you people that don't celebrate Lent because you're not Catholic, step it up. All right.
Right.
And all it is representative of the 40 days Jesus spent in the wilderness leading up to his crucifixion.
Yeah.
That's all.
Give it up.
It don't mean you're Catholic or Protestant or Baptist or whatever.
It means you're a Christian.
Yeah, there you go.
A good practice in Christian. So that you could take home to your parents.
Yeah, exactly. You know? So all right, we gotta remember to do our honorables before our ones.
Yep.
Or threes. Is it ones or threes?
Ones.
Okay. So yeah, just dive right in there, brother.
All right, number 10. If you're a good Christian, you shouldn't be doing this anyway. I got beating your meat.
I almost put it in my list.
Did you really?
But I didn't.
Yeah, don't touch yourself.
Okay.
That goes for you, ladies. No playing. You can't be Skrillex. You can't be DJing down there.
Sticks.
Yep.
DJing, yeah. mixing it up on the ones and twos.
Can't do that.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, solid.
Especially you too. That's just gross. I mean, whatever gets you off. It's what it is. But after 40 days, go back to the two.
Get back after it, you know? Okay. Yeah. So, I should have seen that one coming. That's, I mean, 40 days is quite a run.
You know? That's worse than what, the no fat November?
Yeah. Cause I mean, November's just a month.
Yeah. This is a month.
Oh,
no, not
November. Yeah.
Yeah. No, not November. That's it. That's worse. Giving up for 40 days. That's a bigger testament.
Yeah.
So
good luck.
Good luck. I'm throwing the gauntlet down. Y'all can't do it.
I'm actually going to try and do most of my list. 10 is a lot, though, to give up. Stuff.
Yeah, I'm going
to
try
stuff that you actually do, you know?
This one, I try to give it up for New Year's, but I'm circle back to it for Lent. I got soda. Any type of carbonated cold drink.
Carbonated. So what about just soda water?
That's different.
Because there's no calories.
There's, like, no calories in that. If it's a calorie and carbonated and it's not beer, I'm not drinking it.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah, a lot of these are going to be somewhat a reference to New Year's resolution.
Yeah, because this is like your do-over.
It's like other side of the same coin kind of situation.
Yeah, but it's like a do-over. Like, oh, I miss it. Let's circle back to it.
And we only got to do it 40 days this time.
Yes. All right, number 8. Same thing. Hitting the snooze button.
Ooh, wait.
Was that close?
Oh, that's in my honorable. I thought I put it. Yeah, shit. Dude, that snooze, bro. Oh.
It's killing me this past 2 weeks, dude. I was doing good up until about February.
I actually haven't been doing good about it up till this week. I just kind of started, like, at least getting up. I kind of sleep through the first round because, like,
I hit that bitch 3 times this morning.
Anytime Jager crashes on the couch, I hear him yelling from the living room, "Turn your alarm on!" Like, because it's loud downtown. So, like, the streets are loud. I'm just like, I can sleep through anything at this point. You know what I mean?
That's not good.
Right. I mean, I want to get up when I need to get up, but I'm just used to the racket. So, like, it's hard for the alarm. Like, no, I kind of wake up on the second time around on the alarm.
Yeah.
But I'm bad about snoozing.
Yeah, I hit that thing 3 times this morning.
There's something about that 8-minute nap you get.
I don't know what it is. It's like you're starting your day off with a little nap.
Exactly.
Let's hack it. Okay.
Okay.
Just set your alarm earlier. And you keep hitting that snooze.
That's what I do.
Then there you go.
But no, the problem is I should do the opposite. I should set it at the last possible time I can get up to where I have to get up when it goes off. So I don't have the option to snooze.
That's hardcore.
Yeah, don't give yourself the option. But
I don't think I'm disciplined enough for that.
Yeah, it's tough. All right, so my number 10. I got complaining.
Yeah.
I actually did dig through some lists, and complaining was in a bunch of them.
That's kind of like what
I'm kind of complaining right now, but like I don't really complain a lot. I just kind of take things for what they are. Just roll with the punches is what it is.
What constitutes as a complaint?
Just whining about nonsense.
Okay, as long as it's nonsense. Yeah, but if it's something that's like within you, like can be fixed.
I guess maybe things you take for granted maybe is also could be complaint. Like if you get home and you forgot to set your AC down cooler and it's hot in your place.
And you complain.
That's complaining.
Yeah.
One, it was your fault. Two, it's like, hey, there's that millions of people on earth that don't even have AC. Quit complaining.
But then again, you come home from work, your AC's broke. You can complain, I think.
I don't know. Or if like.
I'm complaining.
Or if you got to cut the grass. That's just something you got
to
do.
Or you plan to cut the grass and it starts raining.
Okay. Yeah. Just complaining about anything, honestly.
Yeah.
So cut it out. 40 days. Try to be happy, Earl, or just at least act happier for 40 days. 9 spot. This I have done much better on restricting myself just because I don't allow myself to have it in the apartment in the first place. I got to give up sweets.
So no cordial cherries?
Oh, dude, I better go get some quick. Dude, I forgot. I got to add that to my
shot. That's how they know you're trash. You preach about them, but you always forget them.
Yeah, because I don't eat sweets, dude. I just said that.
It's bad.
No, I don't eat them at all. Well,
I know nobody does.
No, just sweets in general. All I have left in here now is like a little bit of dark chocolate. I got to go ahead and knock that out before Lent.
I think I'm going to hop on that new sweets bandwagon. Just see what happens.
And
cut that out along with the sodas, dude. I'll probably lose about a good 20.
I'm down like 8 pounds.
Nice.
But yeah, like, so sweets though, I don't know where you draw the line on that. Does that include like Cokes, Sprites,
yeah,
like sodas?
Anything with like corn syrup, artificial sweetener, and sugar.
Well, what, so I have like Nature Valley, it's like dark chocolate.
It counts.
But it's like a healthy snack.
But it's still sweet.
It's like a granola bars with like almonds and peanuts and stuff.
Does it have
it
any
also
sweetener?
Has Does it have dark sweet- chocolate in it. It's like a healthy snack. Like I eat the little blueberry wafer things for breakfast. Right.
Instagram poll.
Okay.
Let the people decide.
What defines a sweet? Oh, also, pretty much all positive feedback on doing another live up. So we're going to try. I got an idea. It's most likely going to be a Friday or a Saturday night. Most likely a Friday, maybe like a 8 to 10 or a 7 to 9 kind of situation.
Mm-hmm.
Like at one of the bars before, like it starts getting ratchet. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I kind of like the ratchet though.
Yeah, but kind of hard for us to record a podcast in the middle of the ratchet.
It might be great. I mean, let me be devil's advocate here.
I hear you.
You'll get some people on here saying some ignorant shit.
That would be funny. Just be posted up all tucked off in the corner. People just coming up, just yelling random stuff in the mic.
Yeah, that'd be hilarious.
We could workshop it, you know?
I mean, I'm not hating the idea.
So my 9 spot, I got sweets. My number 8 spot, I got cursing.
I can't do it.
I tend not to,
I
tend not too much in the, not to do too much in the first place, but, you know.
I'm going to make my kids do that for Lent.
Your kids curse
all the time.
Nice. It's also just a self-discipline thing, you know, which basically all Lent is a self-discipline thing. It's supposed to represent you.
The only time my son curses when he repeats something, like he tells on me when I'm cursing, he like, oh, daddy said motherfucker.
Well, yeah.
My daughter though, she'll just let it fly. She don't care. Like we open up the garage over the weekend, it's raining. She goes, oh, it's fucking raining.
No way, dude.
Swear to God. I'm like, I look at my wife and we're like, do we correct it? Just don't draw attention to it.
Right.
Like, what do you do here?
I hear you. Just let her get it out the way early. She won't do it as much later.
She doesn't do it at school.
Nice.
So I can't complain.
So yeah, cursing in the 8 spot.
All right. Number 7. This is one I think I can knock out easily. No phone at dinner.
Okay. Well, you shouldn't be doing that anyway. That's rude.
Sometimes I eat by myself.
Oh, so not even when you're eating.
Even when I'm eating.
Okay.
Just enjoy the moment.
So just leave it like on the coffee table or
that
something.
That even goes to like no TV either.
That's about the only, well, only time I even watch TV, I'll throw on something real quick while I eat. And then.
I'm not going to eat in silence though, you maniacs. I'm probably going to put like a podcast on or put on some music.
Okay. So you may be learning something or just jamming some tunes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like no TV, no screen, nothing.
All right.
I'm going to try that.
Give it a run, dude. No, it's only 40 days. Man up.
Yeah, I could do 40 days.
40 days is nothing.
That ain't shit. That's a month and like a week and a half.
Yeah.
I like that. All right. Number 6. I try this every year around Lent. I fail within like the first 5 days.
Okay.
Because it's a literal physical addiction.
I know. Wait, I know where you're about to go and we're going to get back to it.
All right. You sure?
I'm pretty good. Wait, what is it?
Hold on. All right, we're going to get back to
it. All right, we're going to get back to it. That was your 7-6?
That was my 7-6.
All right. My number 7 spot. Okay, I don't do this willingly. It's just the way my brain operates.
Girls under 25.
Whoa. Whoa. No. I got given up for Lent. I got blacking out.
40 days, dude.
I never mean to. It's like, okay.
Who plans to get blackout?
Well, though? You remember back in the day.
That's back in the day. That's kid shit.
When you're going out, it's like, all right, we're getting rowdy tonight. Let's hammer shot.
We're getting ratchet.
Yeah. Not. I mean, I never.
It's Turkey Neck Tuesday. Let's go.
Exactly. Free Turkey Neck Tuesday. No, like I never do it on purpose. It's just be like, you know, I got two or three, you know, like, oh, you know, I had a shower beer when I was getting ready. Then I made a drink to walk to meet the homies. And then we're two drinks in and one of the homies already forced everybody to take a shot. Now you're like five, six drinks in and you don't even realize it, you know? And then all of a sudden, just don't remember getting home, you know? It's not like I'm blacking out, like stumbling and slurring all over the place. My brain just shuts down on me.
Yeah.
So I'm going to try and avoid that. I just got to keep a count on my drinks, apparently.
Yeah.
One drink or less per hour.
Mixing in water.
Yes. I don't know. I've been failing bad on that, dude.
Dude, I've been pounding water lately.
Well, I mean, I still drink like 2 gallons a day, but like once I start.
I think I'm up to 2 gallons a day. Like I'll be chugging shit at work.
Once I start like drinking for the evening though, then I forget about the waters till I wake up and I chug some more.
Mm-hmm.
So, seven spot, I got blacking out. Six spot, this one's going to be tricky, but I've been needing to do it anyway. I got credit cards.
That's a damn good one. I didn't even think of that.
Got to give up credit card usage for Lent.
But to increase your credit score, you still got to have active credit. It means you got to use it.
No.
Yeah.
Not for just 1 month. Well, not for 40 days, bro.
Just get a tank of gas on it and you're good.
As long as you pay it off immediately.
Or get a dozen eggs. I mean, shit, you might default.
yeah. Use it. Pay it right off.
Yeah.
But no, just credit cards. Give it up.
All right, my number five. I'm going to do this all year from now on.
Okay.
I got snacking after dinner.
Ooh.
That's a tough one. After dinner, I'm done for the day.
Okay. Now, that gets tricky depending on what time you eat dinner.
I know. Sometimes my kids be like, I'm hungry now. Oh, God. Sometimes we'll be.
What, at like 5 o'clock?
Shit, dude. 4. Mm. They'd be getting home from school. I'm hungry. We're like, might as well just cook.
Ooh, that's tough. I'm just
going to pound water instead.
Well, I've been trying to eat by like 6:30 at the latest.
That's like the perfect dinner time, 6:30.
But then if I'm feeling nice and light and I check myself on, like I've been monitoring myself a lot, trying to cut some weight slowly, just dwindle down.
Mm-hmm.
So if I'm real light one evening, and I get on the scale a pound less than what I thought I was going to be, it's like, okay, well, I guess I'm going to have that bag of popcorn with a movie.
I'm getting all the popcorn out of the damn house for this.
I'm
not buying popcorn for the rest of the year because I know if I see it, I'm going to pop a bag and watch something.
Well, and still, though, I do the 100 calorie bags. So it's basically like nothing.
It's still something, though.
Right.
That's 100 calories. If you do that every night for a whole week, that's 700 calories.
Yeah, I only do it like twice a week, though, dude. I don't care.
That's 200. That's how many calories a month?
That's two drinks, bro.
All right. So number four, this is one I'm challenging you on. Online shopping.
That was your number
four.
That'll roll right into my number five. I got giving up Amazon.
I'm talking online shopping in general.
Online. So the only online shopping I do is Amazon.
Okay. So no Amazon.
Well, 95%. I'm trying to think.
Well, when you say no Amazon, does that go for like Amazon Video? Like renting movies?
No, that don't count.
I don't know.
Just because, I mean, if it was on Netflix, I would have got it on Netflix.
But it's free.
Amazon.
But if you rent, it's like $3. That's still online shopping.
Ooh, good point. Mm.
So what you going to do? 40 days, man up. Can't rent a movie for 40 days.
All right. Deal. All right. Amazon. I am doing the credit card and the Amazon one for sure.
Okay.
But yeah, so
your bank account will thank you.
You said, yeah. Online shopping. Actually, I kind of lied because I did order about $400 worth of black and white prints, to hang up on my wall.
That's in the past. We look into the future. We live life through the windshield, not the rearview mirror.
Yeah, I'm trying to think of what else I shop on. Like Amazon is just so quick and easy and convenient.
It is.
So all I'm gonna do is just stock
especially
up.
Especially when you got that.
I'm gonna just stock up on everything Monday, basically.
Question.
I mean,
using your Amazon points, does that count as online shopping?
Yeah.
Okay.
For sure.
It's free.
Oh, I see what you're saying. What do you mean Amazon points?
Like if you have an Amazon credit card, get your points.
Well, then that'd be credit card. But your points were already.
there
accumulated.
I got like $70 worth of Amazon points.
I'll allow it. No, because you could still save them. No, you need to save them.
All right, for 4 days, I'll save them.
Yeah. So credit cards. Oh, wait, no, Amazon was my five. My number four spot, I believe, was going to be your number seven or six. I got caffeine.
Dude, yeah, caffeine. That's so hard because my body has built up a physical addiction. I get the caffeine headaches like a motherfucker.
I really don't, because like basically every Sunday, I don't drink an energy drink because I'm too scared. I'm too hungover. I got the shakes too bad.
Getting the shakes when you're hungover, that's a bad.
Yeah, combo. I ain't about to pile a 200 milligrams of caffeine on top of it.
Mm-mm, can't do it.
Just thinking I'm gonna have a heart attack. You know,
not worth it.
So I'm gonna try to do caffeine. Oh.
I try it every year, and I always tap out within like 4 or 5 days.
And I do manual labor too. I need that little extra juice, you know.
Green tea. It's not.
That's caffeine.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
What is it then?
It's its own little thing.
Yeah, okay. Its own little thing.
It's like B, what is it? B3?
No, dude. It's caffeine. In green tea? 72% sure it's caffeine. Or one of those versions of caffeine, what like
very minimal taurine. Caffeine. Okay, you're technically correct.
Okay. You remember like there's like taurine or
it's only 30,
arginine
it's only 30 milligrams of caffeine. I mean, come on. That ain't shit.
That's still caffeine.
That ain't shit, dude. That's pussy amount.
So that was my 5-4.
All right, my number three. I challenge the fellas to stop beating their meat. Ladies, I challenge you. No more filters.
Ooh.
For 40 days, when you post a picture, you gotta no
be,
filter.
Just be real?
Be real for 40 days. If you can't do that, then something's wrong.
Yeah. I mean,
I think filters should be outlawed anyway.
No, or there at least should be a thing where you can hold the screen and it erases the filter.
We got to get on that technology.
So like, I don't know how much editing you do on Instagram.
Or every filter comes with like a little watermark so people know it's a filter.
There you go. Watermark. Or like I will say, for like the business account, when I'm posting like pictures of like cabinets and stuff,
mm-hmm.
I go through and tweak like the brightness and the shadows to where you can see the cabinets. Good.
Yeah, but it's still the real cabinet. You can tweak shadows. That's fine. Get the real picture.
Right, but no, what I'm saying
you're enhancing
is
the realness.
Whenever you edit a photo, you can like before you post it, you hold it down and it'll show you the original, and you let off and it shows you how it is when you after.
Yeah, like
edit.
The live photo.
No.
Oh, really?
Like you hold it down and it reverts back to pre-editing, and then you let back off and it goes to post-editing. So if you're scrolling through Instagram and you just held down a picture and it showed you the raw picture and then let off and it shows you the filtered picture.
Yeah. That's what you mean.
I don't know.
So yeah, get rid of the filters. Like, let us see those crow's feet. Let's see those forehead wrinkles. I want to see that vein in your forehead.
So do you mean real life filters as well? Like no lip filler, no Botox for 40 days.
Well, we'll piggyback it. I want to see y'all do it. If you cannot give
up
that
real,
if
natural.
You cannot give up artificial beauty, then you got deeper problems.
For just 40 days.
If you can't give it for 40 days.
Then you go right back to it.
And get back on the horse.
Yeah, you can go get all tuned up, tightened up for
spray tan,
Easter Sunday.
Spray tan counts too. No spray tan.
Okay.
No spray tan for no extensions.
Ooh, now we're going too deep now.
They can't achieve without the weave.
Just all natural.
All natural. Hey, I'll go all natural. I do it every day.
Yeah, I can't think of anything that I have been doing some tanning.
Natural sunlight,
tanning bed.
Nope, gotta get rid of it. That's a filter.
I just do it every now and then, just to keep knock the edge off of the paleness.
And spoiler alert, ladies, go out to the bar. These dudes, they're pounding drinks. They got their own filter. It's called beer goggles.
Yep, that is our version of a reverse natural filter.
Yeah. So hey.
That was your three?
That was my number three. No filters.
And that is also a segue into my number three. This one a lot of people do. I would do it if it weren't for the fact that I'm actually currently trying to boost our presence. I got social media. I know a lot of people that give up Facebook.
We'll
for
get
that.
There.
Okay. All right. We'll get there. That was my three spot.
My number two, booze.
Booze?
Booze. Alcohol in general.
Alcohol in general. That's aggressive.
Like detox for 40 days. Yeah. I know it's boat season. You can't do it.
We're going to get back to that.
All right.
That was your two?
Yes. You giving up River Rats for Lent?
No.
That's an addiction, baby.
My number two. No, it's not, dude. My number two spot. I do
bad bitches are my problem. River Rats are your vice.
I do this. I do this one every year. I got give up fast food.
Yeah, I should have put that. I didn't think about it.
I'll
throw that in the honorable.
It's kind of easy, but kind of not. Like, pretty much on the weekends is, like, nowadays, I only get fast food maybe once during the week, maybe once or twice on the weekends, just because I generally am just kind of lounging and too lazy to, like, make any food.
All right, but here's a hack for that. If you want to give up fast food, call in an order at a local restaurant.
Well, that's way more expensive.
Okay, just get, like, an appetizer or something.
And if I want food, I want it now.
Yeah, just call it in. Get in your car. I'll be ready by the time you get there.
Nah, dude, I ain't doing all that. That's
a lot more convenient, actually.
No. So
you just don't want to get out of your car.
No, I give up fast food to encourage me to cook more.
That makes sense.
It also forces you to cook, learn, be a better, healthier person, you know, just in general.
All right.
Fast food is that's pretty much, I've been doing that one for 5-6 years now.
It's just hard with kids.
They're
so picky eaters. I say, fuck it, let's go to Chick-fil-A, get them something.
Or you can just cook them tenders and fries. You get your air fryer.
They hate it. They hate the air fryer. They hate the microwave, anything. They
get a deep fryer, dude.
Dude, you need to use that.
Burn your house down.
Get a pressure cooker while you're at it. Pressure cook some nails.
Mm-hmm.
So honorable mention, I'll throw fast food in there. The only honorable mention I had was watching the news.
Oh, well,
like unplug, like
you shouldn't be doing that anyway. The news sucks.
It does. But there's so many people that are addicted to rage watching the news. They want to find something to be pissed off.
These people have problems.
That's why they need to give up for 40 days. They're going to understand how.
You don't have to live in that world.
Like, if they give this up for 40 days, they're going to realize, hey, I'm much happier.
It's manufactured
to piss
nonsense.
You off.
Yeah.
We are statistically speaking, we're living in the safest time in human history.
Yeah. Every year.
So they got to find ways to manufacture news to justify being on 24 hours.
Yeah. It's dumb.
Yeah. We're safe. Like, everything is all good. There's nothing to be pissed off about.
Yeah. No. I actually don't really trust most people that watch the news.
Except the Baseball Hall of Fame. That's the only thing we get pissed off about.
What?
The dude that got in from the Cardinals, that third baseman guy.
What are you talking about?
You haven't been keeping up with big league takes?
Uh-uh.
Oh, dude, you got to get on that. Like,
I ain't really been paying attention to too much social media in general.
Well, that's good.
Yeah.
That's good. So, yes, watching the news. Just unplug from it. That's 40 days. 40 days. Just don't pay any attention to it.
That's your only honorable?
Only honorable.
So, my honorables were snoozing, TV, liquor or alcohol in general, music in your car.
Oh, fuck. Okay. Listen to the Perfect 10 podcast instead.
There you go.
And give us 5 stars.
The most obvious one, I got meat, just because that's a standard.
No, I had meat, kind of.
There you go. I got just sin in general.
I like to sin.
It's kind of the point.
It's like that thing in Blazing Saddles.
Yeah.
I really like sin.
premarital sex. That one's easy for me since I'm not doing it anyway.
Hey,
you know,
I'm married, so that's for y'all.
Exactly.
That's for you.
You can rail away. You rail away.
Yes.
So that's my only honest.
Well, when it comes to premarital sex, do you buy into the poop hole loophole?
No, dude. That is a false.
It doesn't count.
Penetration is penetration, dude.
Oh, so you can't go in like the mouth?
Well, it's
you're penetrating their gums.
It's intercourse.
Okay. What about over the pants stuff? Does it count? I'm trying.
I ain't doing none of the over the pants stuff. Use your own judgment on that one.
If man, if you give up beating the meat and no premarital sex, you can.
OTPHJs? Yeah, over the pants hand job.
Yeah.
I actually never experienced one of those. I don't know what's the point.
That's like the most pathetic. That's like, I bet like that's a Pentecostal thing. I bet it's big in like the Mormon
we're like
community.
Soaking.
My man said soaking.
You've heard of that before, right?
Oh, yeah, I haven't heard that term in a long time. Oh, God, that's gross.
Anyway,
the Bible Belt canoes, what we call it down here.
Anyways, your number one is social media.
Yeah. Get off of it. I mean, there's some people I love interacting with on social media. Again, big league takes that's the only reason I mainly get on Facebook these days. Yeah,
pretty much.
That's outside of that, I hardly get on Facebook. Twitter, dude, I'm addicted to the Twit, especially my burner accounts, just going after NBA players.
I never get on Twitter.
Man.
I've
been really mean toward Anthony Davis lately.
Well, he does suck, so.
He deserves it.
Yeah, really the only social media I'm active on is Instagram, and I guess Snapchat is social media.
Yeah.
It's more of like a, I guess it would be like a.
Are dating apps social media for our listeners out there?
I think so. Social interaction over media.
Yeah. And you got to link your socials.
So I guess any social interactions over media is social media.
Yeah.
By definition.
Yeah. And on top of that, it piggybacks off what I said about the news. People's
Facebook sucks.
Yeah, it does suck. I can't wait to get rid of it.
And like
people get on there just to bitch about shit, get mad about shit. That's a good sound, man. What's a better sound? The ice around in a styrofoam cup or a solo cup?
A solo cup's got it, but in a glass is
obvious. Oh, yeah, that's the obvious answer.
Glass, obvious.
That's the obvious one, but do you prefer the ice swirling a styrofoam or a solo?
It sounds better in solo because it's a harder surface. It's got a little more clang to it.
Fair point. I'll agree on that.
But yeah, social media, dude. I know a lot of people that give up Facebook every Lent, which is cool. You know, I mean, nope, I ain't really getting on there anyway. But like, I'm currently boosting our social media presence with the business account stuff. So, which I'm about to start doing this one as well, just because we're so far behind, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But that's a good number one. I had it. You know, that's kind of an obvious one these days. It's sad that has to be something that you have to sacrifice for Lent, but kind of is what it is. You know,
I mean, you can't stay off social media for 40 days. Get help. That's worse than I think the filters is worse. If you can't give up filters for 40 days,
yeah, you need post any pictures of yourself for 40 days.
That's sad. You can't even do that.
There you go. So my number one, this is another one that I've done for the past, I don't know, 6 years. I got beer. Strictly give up beer.
I mean, it's easy because you add other alcohol. You got cocktails.
Okay.
You got Red Bull vodkas.
It's a double-edged sword. Yes. You say it's easy.
But you get drunker.
Exactly. Then
more drunk. More drunk.
Same one. Then you end up, instead of drinking 10 to 12 beers on a river day, you're drinking a whole bottle of Kettle. And turns out.
Charge it to the game, baby.
That's too much.
A whole bottle of Kettle's too much.
Yeah.
You jest. You joker.
You know, so double-edged sword. You know, like one time I gave up beer and I was like, you know what? I'm going to drink wine on the river.
I can tell you right now, that's a horrible idea.
Bad idea. One, you spill any red wine on the boat, bad move.
Yeah.
And then it's me.
Speaking of fruit on the boat, how'd the bananas on the boat go?
Boat has never operated better.
Myth busted.
Yeah, no, that is a fishing myth. It's not a boat myth.
So it's still out there.
No. So apparently, I think it's a redneck thing because I've only heard it from people in the South, but going fishing on charters and stuff.
All right.
Let the record show. Do not show up on a charter fishing run with bananas. They will be very angry.
Smuggle it in.
Yeah.
And it's poking at your pants. So like, dude, I just got a boner. I'm excited to be here.
But
I'm just really happy to be here.
If you're just going cruising or sailing, bananas are fine.
I like a good banana in a cocktail, like a pineapple rum, put a little banana in there. Oh,
okay, I see what you're saying. Sure.
Little banana slices. That's a good refreshing drink right there.
So I'm going to give up beer again. Then see what got me 1 year. I was like, well, somebody was like, well, why don't you just drink? This was like whenever White Claws first came out. They're like, why don't you just drink seltzers? That's not beers. It's like, you know, I guess technically you're correct.
Yeah.
So then you drink 18 White Claws. You're also going to have a bad time. That junk burns your esophagus.
There's something about White Claws that I don't like, but I like High Noons.
Yeah, Nooners are good.
I like Nooners way better than like White Claw. Nooners, I think it's like less carbonated.
Yes, and White Claws have some acidic base to them that it just really burns your throat.
It really does.
So yeah, my number one spot to give up for Lent is beer.
That's a good one.
It's also, it helps you slim up a little bit for summertime, you know. Not as many carbs and all that racket. So,
right.
That was my one spot, dude.
How about just mix on the river? Just do water and vodka.
Yeah. That's what I did last summer. I did.
Oh, you did water. God.
Whoa, dude.
Whoa, dude. I'm belching.
It's scary, dude. That was loud in my headphones. He was like, whoa, what was that?
If I call somebody to wreck because of that, Jesus.
Yeah, we're sorry about that.
At least I didn't fart.
Fair enough. No, I did. I was just being real fancy at a certain point. I would bring like four bottles of water, a bottle of kettle, and
cucumber,
a whole diced up cucumber. And I would drink cucumber, water,
I remember that now.
Kettle. And the problem is the cucumber is so refreshing and delicious. And it, like, you can't really taste the kettle that much. And we ended the day one day. I only had like, I don't know, 2 ounces left in the bottle of kettle. And I still had three bottles of water left. I only drank one bottle of water with like a whole bottle of kettle. It was mind blowing.
It'll sneak up on you.
I'm blaming a lot on the fact that a lot of the ice melted down, which gave me the water base as well.
It is what it is.
Yeah, I mean, yeah.
What can you do at that point?
But anyway, so rundowns.
Rundowns. All right. 10, stop beating your meat, fellas. 9, sodas. 8, hitting the snooze button. 7, phone at dinner. 6, caffeine. 5, snacking after dinner. 4, online shopping. 3, filters of any kind. 2, booze. And number 1 is social media.
All right, my number 10 spot, I got complaining. 9, sweets. 8, cursing. 7, blacking out. 6, credit cards. 5, Amazon. 4, caffeine. 3, social media. 2, fast food. And number 1, lay off the beers.
Lay them off, dude.
But yeah, so, hey, enjoy your Mardi Gras. Get it out.
Send it up. But Wednesday, you got to get right with the Lord.
Right. Gotta cleanse yourself.
Yeah.
Go hit up Ash Wednesday if you want. You know.
Get that little dust on your forehead.
And stay strong for 40 days, people.
Got this.
Stay strong.
You could do it.
And come back.
If you're feeling like you're gonna like fall off the wagon on it, just text one of us.
Yeah.
We'll get your mind right.
We'll get your mind right. But yeah, come back Thursday for nostalgia triggers.
Actually, hold on. Time out. How about this? If I find out you fell off the wagon, I'm sending you a picture of somebody's butthole. It might be mine.
Somehow I knew that butthole was coming.
Wow.
I just read your mind. It was a little ESP right there. I knew you were about to say something about butthole.
Hey, ESPN's everywhere.
But anyway, come back Thursday for nostalgia trip.
That's going to be a fun one.
Get your mind right. I'm going to give you a sensory run. I'm going to bring you back to places you haven't been in years. That's my plan with my list.
And some places you don't want to go back.
Fair.
I got one that will bring you back to places you don't want to be.
Come on now. All right. But anyway. All right. Till then.
Peace.
Till then. Darling, please wait for me till then. No matter when, it will be someday. I know I'll be back again. Please wait till then. Our dreams will live though we are apart. I know we'll keep in our hearts till then, when all